Okay. I think I was just telling the girl upstairs that as a little girl, I had never... I remember my aunt and used to be an avid movie buff. Her picture jo lagti thi na, wo zarur ja kar dekhti thi. And she was like younger to my mother, my mother's sister. Every film that came, she went. Even if it was like a mythological with those bad special effects, because at that time they were really quite bad. And I would go tag along with her. But I had never dreamt that I would one day be on the screen. Life gave me some really extraordinary chances. I think I wasn't thinking at that time. I was young and I took those chances. And I sometimes fell, sometimes was extremely unnerved. But slowly, surely, things worked out. I got Sultanat, where the film was so big, I was like a little ant in the film, because it was filled with the best technicians, the biggest stars, the biggest sets. It was Hindi and English. It was huge, and I was just this college-going girl who just struck lucky. Well, somewhere during the making, I got signed for Kayamat Se Kayamat Tak. I didn't know then, but Nasir Saab, Nasir Hussain, the producer, for me, he was a big person, because I remember seeing some Zamane Ko Dikhana Hai and Hum Kisi Se Kam Nahi, and knowing that it was a Nasir Hussain production. I didn't know that he had had a spate of flops just before they made QSQT. So this was probably, according to people in the industry, this wasn't a great film to sign up with. But what I didn't know. So when I got offered the film, I very excitedly said yes. And then we started making the movie. And I still remember, during the making, people around us would think, ki kya film ban rahi hai, wo ladki hum hum karke baat kar rahi hai, wo kuch ghagra choli pehenke ghoom rahi hai. Kaun hai ye ladka, kaun hai ye ladki? At that time, it was the time of big multi-star cast films. That was a time of big and three hero films. So nobody expected this little QSQT to do anything. And